Does poor sleep cause chronic pain, or is it chronic pain that causes poor sleep? What comes first, sleep problems or chronic pain? Today, I'll answer this question based on the most recent scientific evidence. We'll also talk about what a person can do to improve sleep if they have chronic pain. So let's talk about the association between sleep problems and chronic pain today. A lot of my patients with chronic pain tell me that their sleep quality is poor. They say it takes a long time to fall asleep, then they wake up many times at night and don't feel refreshed when they wake up. They feel like a truck run over their body the whole night and are more exhausted than when they go to bed. Imagine if this happens to you every night, for many months, for many years. It would be terrible, right? A lot of my patients also tell me that it is the pain that wakes them up, that if they turn in bed, they feel pain, and then they are awakened from their sleep. This might be true, like if you have a type of pain that is nociceptive or neuropathic, for example, an inflamed joint, a surgical incision, a nerve compression, like in the elbow, or a carpal tunnel syndrome. But what I'm talking about here today is more about people who do not have a type of pain that is nociceptive or neuropathic. The majority of people with chronic pain have what we call nociplastic pain. This means there is no active injury or damage to a body part. Their pain comes from a sensitization and from changes that occur in their pain system that now makes them feel constant pain without an active disease that needs to be fixed. An example of nociplastic pain is tension headaches. The pain is in the head, it's real, but there is nothing wrong with the head. What they have is a tension that causes pain. This is a type of nociplastic pain. Another example is a person with chronic low back pain. The lower back is okay. Their muscles, nerves, bones, they're healthy. Suppose they have arthritis and degenerative disc disease, but in that case, these arthritic changes are part of the natural adaptation of their body to the environment. And the pain is because their pain system is sensitized and pain signals get amplified. This is chronic, persistent back pain that affects millions of people around the world. Another classic example of nociplastic pain is fibromyalgia, where the person feels pain all over their body, but it doesn't mean that every part of their body is broken, damaged, or with an acute injury. It is because their pain system is sensing danger and sounding the alarm. So back to our topic, sleep problems and chronic pain, which come first? Before I continue, please remember that this video is not medical advice. If you think you have a pain condition, please talk to a healthcare professional. If there is an emergency, please go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. This video is for educational purposes only. Let me show you how scientists answer this kind of question. The first step is to show if there is an association between sleep problems and chronic pain. Scientists do this by bringing people who have chronic pain to the laboratory, for example, fibromyalgia, and then they ask them to spend a night in the laboratory doing a sleep study. They also bring people who do not have chronic pain, and they ask them to do the same sleep study. And then they see if there are abnormalities in the sleep study. And they concluded, yes, people with chronic pain have more sleep problems than people who do not have chronic pain. They showed that these sleep problems are more awakenings, more fragmented sleep, fewer cycles through the different stages of sleep, less time in both REM and non-REM sleep, reduced duration is spent in the restorative stage 3 sleep, which is the deeper sleep that we get, longer sleep latency, longer total sleep time, and as a consequence, lower sleep efficiency. But an association is not causation. Could it be that the chronic pain caused all these sleep problems? The idea that chronic pain causes a sleep problem was what I learned in medical school. This was common knowledge for many years until scientists started doing a different type of study, longitudinal or cohort studies. In longitudinal studies, the scientists start with people who are healthy, and at the start of the study, they include people who do not have any kind of chronic pain. They ask the participants to complete many questionnaires, and then they follow these participants over many years and see who will develop chronic pain. So remember, these were healthy people without chronic pain. Now you have thousands of people being followed for years, 3, 10 years, and then you can see if someone develops chronic pain or not. This kind of cohort or longitudinal study is very time-consuming and expensive, and that's why they are rare in the scientific community. But this is what this Swedish scientist researchers did. Mork and Nielsen published this study in the journal Arthritis and Rheumatism in 2012. They recruited 12,350 women who did not have chronic pain. They did various questionnaires with all of them, and then they followed them for 10 years. At the end, 327 or 2.6% developed fibromyalgia. So they looked at the sleep questionnaires they had done 10 years before. And yes, the sleep abnormalities were there even before they developed fibromyalgia. The women who had sleep problem 10 years before had a much higher risk of developing fibromyalgia. They showed that the sleep problem came before the chronic pain diagnosis. Well, if this is not enough to convince you, another group from England did a similar study and came to the same conclusions. They recruited 1,792 adults, followed them for 3 years. Of this, 131 or 7.3% developed chronic pain. They found that those people who had a known restorative sleep 3 years before were at higher risk of developing chronic pain. And this is the study. What does this tell us? If you are healthy, but you have problems with your sleep, you have a higher chance of developing chronic pain. So now we know what came first. It is the sleep and not the other way around. What scientists are investigating now is what exactly happens in a person with sleep problem that causes them to become more susceptible to developing chronic pain. They're looking at this as potential mechanisms. A sleep problem may lead to changes in neurotransmitters in the brain, like noradrenaline, GABA, and serotonin, which are essential to the pain system, like the top-down pain modulating pathways. Or it could be that the sleep problem messes up the melatonin system in the brain, which could be necessary for pain relief. Or it could be that the sleep problem affects the production of endogenous endorphins, the powerful painkiller produced by our brain's inner pharmacy. It could also be that the sleep problem disrupts the balance between the sympathetic and parasympathetic systems, which are part of our autonomic nervous system. These are areas of future development, but they are very promising. Suppose sleep problems are the cause of chronic pain, depression, fatigue, brain fog, anxiety, and emotional problems. In that case, we can have some hope for treatment in the future. So, what happens if we improve our sleep? Would the pain go away? Scientists and clinicians worldwide have done multiple studies trying to improve sleep, chronic pain, or both. Interventions that aim exclusively to improve sleep, like cognitive behavior therapy for insomnia, are suitable for sleep but do not have much impact on pain. Where the science is going in this area is using multiple modalities to improve different aspects of the patient's well-being. It is not enough to focus only on sleep and hope that their pain will get better. It seems that there is a need to integrate sleep treatment with other components, like emotions, untreated traumatic experiences, sedentary life, poor nutrition, and a lack of socialization and purpose in life. People with chronic pain have a tendency to isolate themselves, not to take care of themselves, and stop enjoying their lives. And that's why I wrote the 8 steps to conquer chronic pain. Sleep is step number 3. But the person also needs to reach all the other steps. Well, if you know someone struggling with sleep problems and pain, send them a copy of my book. And here's the link for you to use. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.